Welcome to V8 DXP. Today we're reviewing the 2019 Volkswagen Touareg, which is in its third generation and the flagship SUV from Volkswagen. And I think the Volkswagen has done a great job in terms of giving it a complete LED presence. So you've got all LED banners that go all around over here. You've got a slit over here as well, and you've got this slip of LED lights that go over here. And it's all LED all over here. Beautiful illumination at night. And the beauty with these lights is actually it's called Matrix LED. And what that does is it actually creates different variations based on your driving conditions, whether you're driving through city traffic or you're driving through an empty panel of road. These lights adapt the beam in such a way that it doesn't obstruct the person that's coming in front while giving you the best visibility. Under the hood sits a 3-liter turbocharged motor that produces a whopping 340 horsepower. And given the size of this SUV, this V6 produces more power than you ever want from this SUV. On the side, Volkswagen has maintained a very clean look, and the wheels that you get with this car really complement the design angles that Volkswagen is trying to put with this car. It's not a boxy design and it looks very, very clean and sophisticated at the same time.
On the back, you've got these really nice design LED tail lights, and so they actually make this way, this shape over here, but the moment you press your lights, this actually completes into be three different squares that comes on. And I think that gives the car a very distinct look, and it's something that's not seen a lot in this particular market. And you've got this really big Volkswagen badging over here, and you've got the way they've written Touareg, very similar to the way that they write the Cayenne in the Porsche, because remember, this is on the same platform as the Q7 and the Porsche Cayenne. So you see some of those elements that get carried across over here. You've got a nice chrome lip over here, you've got your parking sensors, you've got your dual exhaust that comes in over here as well. Now this is a premium SUV from Volkswagen, so obviously you get all the aids of a power tailgate and all of those things. However, on the inside, what you do miss out, which is there in some more American and European models, is the option of power dropping the rear seats, which is missing in this over here. But you do get a nice 12 volt socket where you can put in all the stuff and see what all that can be done to your car. Good amount of storage space. You've got plenty of storage space where you can keep a lot of stuff, plenty of hooks, and you've also got a full-size spare tire that comes in over here, and you've got some storage to keep stuff around there as well. Happily put in a couple of suitcases, it's got no problem, and the seats fold down to do a very good job and give you plenty of space when you should you need to be carrying anything big. The back of the car is also a great place to be. Now this is the seat position where I would normally drive, and you can see that I have a fair amount of headroom and fair amount of knee room as well that's available to me. I'm 5'5" and I can see that plenty of space to walk around with. That's not a problem. Of course, you've got this huge panoramic sunroof that gives you a very airy feel, and you feel like, you know, that you're in a much bigger car than what the size it offers. You've also got a very good panel over here in terms of your screen size, or in terms of your blowers, and you've got individual climate controls that go up over there. And below, you've also got two more USB chargers and also a cigarette lighter in case you want to charge your phones back here as well. So it's got your back passenger that's covered as well. You obviously got the nice piano black finish that goes all around. Nice wooden inlays over here as well. And you've got a good speaker that sits over here. And you've got these shades, which we are now seeing in a lot of these cars. You've got that shade that comes up over here. And it's actually got a vent on the top that actually works. The one place where this car really excels is obviously the screens that it has. You've got a beautiful 12-inch display that sits right in front of your steering wheel over here. And here you've got a massive 15.1-inch display that sits over here that gives you an idea of how digitalized the cockpit is. And Volkswagen calls this in their terminology as a digitalization of their cockpit systems. And I think that although the screen might be a little intimidating when you see it for the first time, it's very easy to get used to, and they've got some really good features that come into this car. And especially when you're using the navigation, it's so useful to be having a screen that's this big. Obviously, when you see it for the first time, you might be like, wow, this is a really big screen, but you really get used to it really quickly. I'm going to talk to you about some of the features that this car offers. So it's got this capacitive touch. So what it does is when you sort of get your fingers towards it, more options come up. As you can see, the menu and all of that stuff comes up as you get your finger closer to it. And when you take it back, it retracts. So if you get it closer, you've got all of these settings. Take it back and those settings sort of retract to give you a much cleaner look You've got it's very responsive, so like you can just swap between two fingers, and you've got the full map that comes up over here. This is sort of your home button, really much like an iPad, and you've got all of these variations where you can all the different stuff. You can look at your trip computer, you can set your favorites, you can set your vehicle status, where you can look at all the warning messages that the car has, you can look at your tire pressure monitoring, and you can look at your oil level and all of that. So yeah, you've got this over here, you can customize all of this to change. You've got these shortcuts over here, your parking sensors, your air care. So what air care is basically, it's sort of like an air filter. So when you press on that, the blower vent goes on and it sort of does a full cleansing of the interiors when you do that. So that's good for people that have allergens and that have all of those issues that come up with them. Now when you drag this, you sort of get all of these functions where it says radio, telephone, media, vehicle, navigation, sound and all that stuff. So for example, if you get into vehicle, you can see all of this stuff and really nice stuff from Volkswagen, you know, like the touches, like this matches the exterior of the car. You've got to have a journey message. You can switch on and off your auto start stop selections, and then you can go in over here and you can look at different stuff. For example, you can go to off-road and you can see all of the things that come in over here in terms of your the angle of your wheel. So if I move this, you can see that changes. And you can go ahead and change this to be displaying something else. For example, if you want to see your compass, if you want to see how high or low the car is, your different temperatures of your engines and whatnot. So that's completely customizable. And I think that's a great touch that these modern cars are making with the addition of the screen that comes up over there. So that's a good thing that you can have. And you can also go ahead and look at the other driver data in terms of see how your fuel efficiency is, how you've been driving. And you've also got the vehicle status, which we just went over. So it's also got Apple Play and Android Auto, so you can use both of those. And then this is obviously to use your Bluetooth devices and whatnot. This is for your radio. And then this brings you back into the vehicle status. And this is for your settings and the plethora of settings that you can do in terms of your controls, in terms of what all you want the car to do, in terms of personalizations and all of that stuff, which I'll not be getting much detail into. Now, here's the thing is that when you want to reduce or increase the volume in any of these touch-based interfaces, we really love it when we get a knob, an actual knob to sort of increase and decrease the volume. And Volkswagen has paid attention to that. So you've got this knob over here. Moving on to this, you've also got in terms of, for example, if you want to change the seats, all you've got to do is tap on this, and there are different settings that come up for your seat, so you can sort of adjust your seat based on these settings over here. You've got all your seat settings that go up over here, your seat depth, your back bolsters, your seat cushion bolsters, everything that comes in over here. Car also comes with a massage feature, so you can actually turn on this massage and it'll start massaging you, and you can also vary the intensity of the massage using this stick over here. There's something called as a balance, where it allows you to put hot air at your back and the cold air at your butt. So depending on what your preferences are, you can sort of balance that out as well. Now, one of the funny thing, which I actually don't quite understand why car makers are putting this, is you can actually change the setting of the passenger seat. So for example, I'm using my seat controls to change the passenger seat. So you can see that I can completely change it using the controls of my seats. So I'm not exactly sure why that's useful, but there are car makers that are putting it now. So this car has it as well. So you've got that going on, and then you can obviously vary all of these other settings that you want that can be done. Going back onto the home menu, like I said, you've got all of these things, you've got all of the stuff that goes on over here, very, very clean, cleanly put in. In terms of the driving dynamics, you've got a very sturdy, a big massive 12-inch display up front over here, and you've got an even bigger 15-inch display on this side, which sort of keeps you entertained and gives you all the information that you need. For the newer drivers, this might be a little distracting, but once you get used to it, you really start to enjoy the huge navigation display that you get and all the vehicle information that comes in over there. You've also got a heads-up display which gives you all the information about your speed, your lane, and all of those other sweet details. The visibility is really good. Even when you're using Polaroid sunglasses, you can still see the heads-up display properly. The build quality and material is, again, typical to Volkswagen. Really high-end, soft-touch materials are all around, and it feels like a very premium car, which it is. Being the flagship, this car does come equipped with all possible stuff that you can imagine, from adaptive cruise control to night vision camera and all the other aids that Volkswagen has in its newer cars that's coming in. The steering feels very light at low speeds, and it stiffens as you speed up, obviously. There's also a certain amount of interference from the active lane assist that Volkswagen's put in, as the steering sort of kicks in when you try to change lanes and you know, obviously that's something that a lot of new cars are doing out, but it's more livable with in this car. Moving on to the interiors over here, you also have a very nice wood finish, which looks very, very premium. And this runs across the entire width of the car. So that's something that for people that are looking at design quality and interior details, this is something that you will really love. And you've also got this gear lever over here, which is aircraft style design, and it's a massive, massive big gear lever that comes in, and you obviously have your gear shift information over here, but the parking is on the lower left side, and this has a very good stay to it. So you can see the parking that comes in over here, and this lever has a very good stay to it, so you can rest your hand like this and it feels like you're piloting an F-16 aircraft. You've got your start stop buttons, and you've got your parking brake, your electronic parking brake, and you've got your auto hold as well. One of the good things that I think Volkswagen has really paid attention to in terms of their audio is it does come with a very good premium sound system, but considering all the screens that Volkswagen has given you, you would expect a volume, you would expect changing volume in your audio system to be a very difficult task. But Volkswagen has really thought this through. There is a dedicated volume knob over here, which is accessible both by the passenger and the driver at the same time. So you don't have to fidget around the screens in case you want to change around the volume. All you have to do is go this up, the sound comes on, and you can drop this down. So this is really good thinking on Volkswagen. They've really thought through what their customers want, and they've put in all the features that they want. You've also got different mode selectors over here, because this is, remember, the flagship SUV. So this is an SUV that Volkswagen offers. So you've got custom mode selectors over here, which sort of change the mode. You've got multiple modes that you can select from. So you've got your Eco, you've got your Normal, you've got your Sport, you've got your Individual, your Off-Road, and obviously your Snow mode. And there are two different variations that you can do in the Auto, which is Auto, and you can also change it to Expert. So these are some of the stuff that Volkswagen offers, and you've also got a hazard switch over here. Now the one that I'm driving is the top of the line version, but there is a blank switch over here. I'm not exactly sure why that is, but there is a blank switch over here. Moving on to the front, you also have your wireless charger over here. Takes in big phones, no problem. We've got two phones, the S10 Plus and the S8, sitting over here. Both of them are charging, and there's still space for a lot of stuff to come in over there. You've got two USB ports over here, and you've also got two very big cup holders. The blower vents are sort of hidden below this entire panel, and you can't really see them, and that's a sweet way of hiding these vents that don't look very obscure when you're driving around town. To the design language on the passenger front as well, you see it's a straight pattern all the way around. These vents are adjustable, and it gives you like it's one big unique system, which gives it a very, very clean and a neat design, and really goes with Volkswagen's design language for 2019. Moving on to the central compartment over here, you've got a big, massive central compartment that you've put in over here. It's got loads of storage space. You can put in lots of stuff. This is also temperature controlled, and there is a small LED light over here that switches on when you open this to sort of see what's inside the compartment. Again, fit and finish is absolutely phenomenal. Really good fit and finish quality. And this is really big, so two passengers can keep both their elbows over here and not have to fight for space to keep your elbows on there. Up front, you've got the standard sun visors, and you've got your tweeters over here, your memory seats, your door closes, and all of that comes in over here. This is the largest sunroof that Volkswagen offers in any of its car, and it opens all the way to the back. So that is one of the key things that makes this 2019 Volkswagen Touareg slightly different from all the other SUVs out there. You've also got very good mirrors that give you good visibility. You've got the lane keep assist inside on this, so you can see that the amber light is on right now. So it sort of reminds you of how it is on the Porsche Cayenne. So obviously this is based on the same platform, so they do a bit of design sharing. Hope you like this review for the 2019 Touareg. I really like this car. It's got some very good accents, and I think that in terms of the competition, it really stands out. So I hope you like this review as well. Please go ahead and like this video and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more car videos. See you on the next one.